not every great video game needs fantasy and flashy storylines of the world almost ending. Sometimes the story of leaving the city behind and taking the plunge into a new humble farm life is all players need to have a good time. Stardew Valley doesn't need all the bells and whistles to be considered a great title. In the flurry of all the fun things to do in this new life, one can find themselves a bit overwhelmed, but don't worry. Every new farmer eventually finds the routine that works best for them. But there are a few tasks and details that most dedicated fans would recommend newcomers prioritize before it's too late. Here are a few things every player should do right away when starting Stardew Valley. First up, watch TV every morning. Making the transition from city life to country life doesn't mean saying goodbye to all pastimes. Taking a quick TV break isn't a bad thing. In fact, it's encouraged. Before each day of hard farm work begins, make sure to watch a bit of TV before heading out. Specific programs will help with various aspects of the game, from giving useful tips to new recipes. Those few extra seconds taken to check what's on TV will pay off in the long run. The weather report is especially useful for picking out the perfect day to upgrade the watering can, as it'll then be with the blacksmith for the next couple days. Next up, invest and build scarecrows. Crops are a farmer's bread and butter, and unfortunately, crows just can't keep their greedy beaks away. Ensuring all crops are flourishing and ready to be sold every morning means protecting them from nearby critters. Don't allow these pests to have their way. Invest in foraging and harvesting items to build a few scarecrows right away. This simple fix will ensure that there aren't any missing or ruined crops every morning that, if left alone, would cost a hefty amount of lost profit. Next up, check the bulletin board every day for quests. The beginning month of the game can feel a little hopeless at times. On top of caring for the crops every morning, it's best to make a habit of always checking the bulletin board just outside a peer's shop. There, the player will find the occasional listing written by other residents of the town, asking for help with miscellaneous tasks. These little quests are a great way to build oneself in the beginning stages of simply waiting for crops to grow. Not only does it help the player get acquainted with the townsfolk, but most importantly, it's a great way of making extra coins each day. Next up, prepare for upcoming seasons. Keeping track of the changing weather is important for everyone, but for a farmer, it means their livelihood. Keep an eye on the calendar. Don't just keep a routine of tending to the garden and buying the seeds in Pierre's stock. Nothing is worse than buying up a fortune of expensive seeds to plant just to have the weather change and for them to stop growing. Each season within the game lasts 28 days. Make it a point to begin planning out if it's possible to grow a crop within the appropriate time frame before the season ends and ruins the whole garden. Next, make friends and gift everyone. Although Stardew Valley is a game revolving around farm life, that doesn't mean there's no time for socializing. Half the game's appeal is within the incredibly detailed and intricate stories for each town resident. Talking to each member of the town is fulfilling on its own, but for those that are looking for even more profound relationships, gifts are a great way to show affection. Remember to gift all the townsfolk to get their friendship meters up, and who knows, maybe that friendship could flourish into something romantic as well. Next up, keep some grass on the farm. Once livestock is available to purchase, those animal friends will become valuable assets to the player's farm. Along with companionship, these animals will bring new sources to sell for good coin. However, these animals, like any other living creature, need sustenance. Make sure to leave a few patches of grass when clearing the plot of land for crops, as these tall grass bushes can then be harvested for hay. Buying hay can be pricey and will ultimately dampen the overall profit that comes from the livestock. Using grass and saving up to build a silo will help with the cost of livestock maintenance in the long run. Next, donate to the community center right away. After a few days, the community center will open up, allowing the player to donate bundles to help repair certain parts of the town. These bundles consist of various items found in-game, ranging from things that are only obtained from livestock to things that can only be found when mining. These bundles also differ in how difficult they are to complete and are separated into seasons. Once the season is over and say one or two items of a bundle are missing, the player will be out of luck. Those items won't be available to harvest or forage for an entire year until the season makes its rounds again. It's a good idea to start collecting these bundles right away, so progress can be made all year round. Next up, make sure to plant crops near water. One of the most common mistakes when starting up the garden area is planting seeds wherever it seems okay. Plan ahead. It's difficult to keep building around the initial plot of soil, and then realize another location would have been better when it's far too late. For starters, make sure to plant the first batch of seeds next to a nearby pond. Watering can be fatiguing, and making the trip back to a water source for a quick refill can take up a lot of time. Avoid this by ensuring that the very first set of seeds planted is next to a pond for easy refilling access. And finally, prioritize the backpack upgrade. A bigger inventory means getting more tasks done for the day. Inventory upgrades should almost always take priority, as making trips back and forth from farm to chest, chest to store, and back can be a waste of time and energy. Players can do themselves a huge favor by putting this upgrade at the top of their list in the beginning stages of Stardew Valley for the sake of convenience, profit, and efficiency. Those were just a few of our tips for beginners in Stardew Valley. Thank you for watching Game Rant. I'm Cameron. We'll see you next time.